Alright folks, how are we getting on? My name is Jack Brown and today we're back with another episode of Riverside Sessions on the UWS Radio YouTube. We are joined by Emma Smith. Take away, Emma.
All I see are girls in tight dresses that fit them perfectly, just like a glove. They'll never know just how much I wish I looked like that. All I see are pretty faces, blue-eyed blondies that everyone talks about. I look at them and I see everything that I lack. Should I invite them to my pity party? Or cry our hearts at them, or say we're sorry? I'll send invitations in the post, we'll play games and see who complains the most. Come along and join the pity party, do me some of the fun, we'll be it's unmissable, talking about how unkissable. This party's second to none. My pity party has begun. There's a boy across the street. I look for a second and our eyes seem to meet. He flashes a smile, seems like he's got it ordered out. See him almost every week. He walks the same route by the willow tree. Every time he makes his way through the town. Should I invite him to my pity party? We'll cry our hearts out and we'll say we're sorry. I'll send invitations in the post. We'll play games and see who complains the most. Come along and join the pity party. To miss out on the fun would be bittersweet. Please come, it's unmissable. Talking about our unkissable. This party's second to none. Party has begun. All we want is to be picture perfect, but we tell ourselves we're not worth it. Only got myself to blame. I hate the player and the game, cause it's all on you. Every little thing that you say and do will never be enough. God, I hope you like my pity party. Your lives are perfect, so I hope you're happy. Take a seat, don't smile, spoil the fun. Have a piece of cake, I'm so glad you could come. I'll send invitations in the post. We'll play games and see who complains the most. Come along and join the pity party. To miss all the fun would be bittersweet. Please come, it's unmissable. Talking about our unkissable. This party's second to none. My pity party has begun.
Alright, Emma, how are we getting on? How are you doing today?
Good, thank you. How are you?
Yeah, dead good, dead good. So, we're going to start off by asking you a few questions before we get into your next song. You're playing a ukulele. First time we've had a ukulele on Riverside Sessions this year. Why did you pick up the ukulele? What made you play it?
I was in my friend's house and I saw that she had like just like a cheap wee tenor one, and I just picked it up and had a go, and it's a lot easier than the guitar, so it's the easy way out, I feel. But nah. I really enjoyed it, so just thought I'd stick to it, and it's a bit different, so I like it.
That's totally fair. And as you said, you picked it up when you were at your friend's house. You started like trying to get into it yourself. Do you remember what the first song you learned was?
I think it was Wasn't Expecting That by Jamie Lawson, because it was probably one of my favourite songs at the time, and I just wanted to play it and learn it, and yeah, I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, so it's really spurred your journey on to what it has become now.
Yeah.
Last night, you were playing the 13th note in Glasgow. How was that experience for you?
It was amazing. It was really good. I've never played a gig by myself before. I've done loads in bands, and obviously I busk as well, but doing my first gig by myself was really insane, and everyone else there was amazing as well.
Quite a surreal experience.
Nice. Yeah, it was incredible.
Perfect. Well, I want to hear the next song.
We walked along the shore, the sand through our toes. We watched the waves crash, felt the water by our ankles. Walked hand in hand, felt your pulse through your fingertips. Everything was perfect, there was one thing I couldn't miss. Can't help but wonder, have you done this all before? Did you do this with her? Am I just walking in the
for my glass of wine. It should feel perfect, but I know you wish the stains weren't mine. Can't help but wonder, have you done this all before? Did you do this with her? Am I just walking in the footprints she's already made? Was it better before? Am I just walking in the footprints she's already made?
So, back in, you're from Fort William, you used to busk there quite a lot. How has busking actually affected your music career thus far? Have you got any memorable moments or...?
I think it's really, like, helped me be a lot more confident, because obviously when you busk, no one really has to listen to you. And, like, it really makes a difference, because it makes you think, like, obviously if they're giving you money, they've walked past and thought that you've actually been okay. So, like, it really boosted my confidence, and I got... Like, some people come up to me and say amazing things. Some people come up to me and say some not so amazing things. But it also helps you learn, like, that you have to take criticism and, like, just to take it on the chin. Like, don't be so personally attacked by it, because often they don't even know what they're talking about. And
yeah.
Sometimes they're trying to help. Sometimes they're just trying to be mean. But you just need to get on with it. But it's really helped my confidence, definitely, performing live.
So a bit more questions about the future. Say in 10 years' time, if you could play any venue or festival, where would you play and why?
I think either the O2 or the Barrowlands in Glasgow would be really cool, because they're just, like, really big venues, and it'd be such, like, a memorable event. And yeah. It'd just be, like, a dream to fill out that many, like, have that many people want to come and see me. It would be amazing.
Yeah, definitely. And finally, you could feature with any artist in the world, anyone at all, who would they be?
I think it would probably be Joshua Bassett, because I'm really inspired by his songwriting, and I just love all of his songs. Like, I always listen to his songs and I'm like, I wish I wrote that. So probably Joshua Bassett.
So you think that if you wrote a song with Joshua Bassett, it'd really improve your career as well, as you'd learn a lot of him?
Yeah, definitely.
Spot on. Well, we're going to take it away by a cover. Thanks very much for listening, folks.
I just want you closer. Is that all right? ask your question, just let me hold you. Don't shrug your shoulders, no. Lay down beside me and sure I can.